pistol whip you to the gum break. You can keep your life. I can read your mass Times Square to the speed of light. I'm a light beam. Carbonated better when these devils is jealous and they trying to steal my melanin. Two guns sitting in vinegar, get the rust off. Soon as one of you niggas front, you getting dust off. Bloody knife flow, it's the return of OJ. Cleaning my gun, smoking while I'm bumping the OJs. Got a way to cocaine, shorty blowing like Coltrane. Dose with my dose, ooh, I'm colder than O'Shea. I'm dark matter, but shining with a bright aura. Your girl call like Ikama, but that's another Sora. So many guns like a mathematic algorithm.
I noticed that, like, it was a saying going around called, like, Lego. So I'm like, damn, I'm like, man, that shit kind of weak. Like, and I noticed, I'm like, damn, if a celebrity say something like the populace, the people just going to go with it. So I'm like, you know what? I'm Ice. I'm just going to be like Frio, like on some Kobe shit, like Kobe. So it'd be like Frio. And, you know, Frio, that's Spanish for cold. So I was like, yo, you know what? So when I came home in 2010, I started, you know, got back on my dribble with the rapping shit. So I used to always be like Frio in the beginning of this shit. So then niggas just started calling me that shit. So then I broke it down to an acronym. So it actually stands for real and intelligent people only. So it's like my music is for real niggas and smart niggas at the same time. Because, you know, niggas ain't trying to be crashing out with no dumb shit. You know what I'm saying? Like we take whatever money we accumulating and we getting. And we, you know what I'm saying, we switching sides. We doing whatever we do, smart shit. You know what I'm saying? Getting money, still taking care of their kids. Being on principles, being on good timing, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So that's the vibe with that.
Tell me something about New York. I've never been through there. I've been past there. On the road.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
But tell me something about Utica and shit.
Utica is like, it's a place like, that shit is like a boulevard of broken dreams type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot of niggas with a lot of good talent, a lot of good potential that could have made it out. And they ended up being, you know, succumbing to the bullshit, the street life and shit. So I know niggas that was like in college with Mello and niggas that's in the A going crazy. And he was on the same level type shit. And it's like a few different niggas and they just crashed out. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a black cloud over this city. It's just like every other inner city ghetto. You know what I'm saying? Murder rate high. Ain't nothing to do but trap, get money. The regular bullshit, my nigga. Like, It ain't nothing too special. It's a small city, but like I said, it's like a boulevard of broken dreams. A lot of talent, a lot of, you know what I'm saying? It's a hood everywhere, so don't think it's sweet just because you upstate, you know what I'm saying?
How long you been an MC?
I've been an MC all my life. I remember my mom's playing music in the crib. I'm like 4, 5, 6 years old. So, you know, when you cleaning up, old Nanny and them had the church music, but my mom was playing all that Uptown shit. LB Shore, Jodeci, Heavy D, all that shit. So I've been being in the crib youngin', like 5, 6, freestyling, making songs. So this shit always been in me, like that shit in me, not on me. So just that type of shit. But I recorded my first shit at like 14, 15, just fucking around, but I always had a passion for it. And I just stepped it up more when I was in, right before I did my bid and shit. So I've been recording professionally for a minute.
So you was writing when you was up the way?
Hell yeah. Not a lot, though, because, like, man, you know what I'm saying? You trying not to keep so much shit, try to block out a lot of the bullshit, especially in the town and keeping your head on the swivel and just knocking that time down every day and shit. So I wrote a little something, but nowhere near, like, how niggas be coming home with thick-ass notebooks and shit. Right. Like, nah, I looked at it like, yo, if I'm going to do this time, I'm going to get better. I'm going to get my body right, my mind about to be better. Everything, but I'm about to just level up on all fields. You know what I'm saying? So that was my main focus.
Was you confident enough to get in the ciphers in the yard and shit like that?
Every now and then. When I played the yard, I mostly was just hitting the bar, go to the weight pile, locking that joint, and then spending the yard with my son. Regular shit. Word.
Tell me how you feel about I don't want to call it the resurgence because it's the first time that it happened.
Right.
But how do you feel about the energy that's populating the upstate New York corridor? That's what I like to refer to.
Yeah.
Utica, Rochester, Syracuse, Buffalo, Niagara Falls, mm-hmm. Albany. I can go on, Middletown, right. Newburgh. I can go on and on and on, man. Facts. It's all these treasures up there in the mountains and shit. But yeah. Tell me how you feel about the focus being.
I love it.
Having an equal opportunity yeah. right now.
I love it, man. I love it. You know what I'm saying? It's like, because it's like we finally getting a voice. You get what I'm saying? Like, when I first started fucking around, like, you literally had to go to, like, New York City or, like, a big spot to really get noticed type shit. So it's like, thank God for the internet and technology. You get what I'm saying? You dig me? So it's like, you know how that shit go, man. It's like, throughout all history, throughout all civilizations, wherever the focal point was at, then that shit just starts spreading out. Like, and we the niggas that's forefronting and pioneering that energy that niggas love. You know what I'm saying? That nostalgia, that real shit. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? We holding it. You know what I'm saying? It's like we like the Templars of this shit. You know what I'm saying? We holding it together. We keeping it what it was. Keeping it pure.
You came home and got straight on your music shit, or you were triggered by the 2015 Trust Gang cipher. I believe that started it. You remember that cipher?
Yeah.
That cipher meant a lot to upstate New York, yeah. right? Did that trigger something in you?
That shit was a flagship. That shit was a monument. Nah. Like, I came home hitting the ground running.
Okay.
Because, like, I felt like, even in my town, like, in my town, there was only, like, a handful of, like, niggas that was really like rapping for professionally and really doing it on a professional level.
Right.
And then I came home and it was like a million rappers. I'm like, God damn, what the fuck going on? So I just came back like, niggas will forget about you when you leave. I was gone 4 years.
Right.
So I'm like, nah, niggas gonna remember my name. Niggas forgot? I'm gonna show you niggas something. So I just came, this my passion. Like I said, man, this shit in me, not on me. So like, this is the only thing I really wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? So it's like niggas wanted to be whatever in school. They said, like, I always wanted to be a rapper. You get what I'm saying? Like, niggas only knew me for rapping and trapping and shit like that. So right. I ain't play no ball. I ain't did none of that shit.
You didn't hoop?
I ain't hoop.
Oh, you missed out, my nigga.
I know.
We was
know.
Getting busy, my nigga.
I know.
We had all the bitches.
I know. See, but the thing with me is that I always pride about myself is that even to this day, it's like, always did what I never was one of them niggas that did shit because everybody else was doing it.
Right.
See, now, like, rapping and a lot of other shit that a lot of dumb shit niggas do now is because it's fad. It's a trend. So right. It's like I don't even smoke bud, my nigga. Like, I stopped smoking bud, locked up in 07. Hit that shit, the stick, and I'm like, the fuck am I doing? I'm high in jail. Like, I gotta watch these niggas. I gotta make sure a nigga don't drop a slip on me. I gotta make sure the CO ain't looking at me crazy.
Right.
And I'm just like, man, fuck that shit. So since then, I don't even fuck with it because I don't. It's a deterrent to what I'm doing. You get what I'm saying? If I was getting high all day, I wouldn't be as productive,
right.
as successful I am now. So sports just ain't my thing, my nigga. Like, if it ain't for me, I ain't fucking with it. I do what I'm good at. Right. I like to focus on my strengths.
So how did you go about establishing yourself musically when you got out of jail? What did you do? Freestyles, DVDs? You know, what was the process to get to here?
What I did was, first came home, had a couple niggas that, you know, I knew from like the sandbox and just from being in the street. They was doing their thing. They was more or less like at their peak while I was locked up. So when I came home, it was more like on a decline. So I just linked up with my niggas. We were recording shit and making videos and this, that, and the third. And just, I did everything. So that's the thing, I did everything also. So even though I was recording with my niggas, like whenever it was a cypher going on, whatever it was like, this one, battle rap was real big in my city too. Like that shit done died down, but I'm at all the battles. I'm just getting my face known out there, displaying my talent any way possible. Even though I'm not like a battle rapper per se.
Yeah. Would you like, try it? Would you get out there?
It ain't my style. Like, I'll smoke a nigga on the track.
Yeah.
But as far as like that, because that's a whole different other art form.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So it's just like, it just ain't really my thing. So even though the niggas that was doing that, some of my niggas was doing it, after they will always have like a cypher or somebody out there with a camera, I'm like, yo, let me hear a Hot 16. And I always took the opportunity to spit my shit. And niggas always fucked with it. And then just going in the studio, link with niggas, and niggas just started requesting me and shit like that. So I just build it up. It's just one step at a time.
Right. You submitted a project to me.
Right. Frio season. Yeah.
How many tracks? It's been a minute.
I think it's like nine. It's
nine been a tracks. Several of them was fire, real hip hop.
Appreciate
shit.
That.
The production. Who does the production?
This dude named Othello Beats did about the bulk of it. Like the bulk of it. Probably about four or five joints. I don't know him personally. I just ran across some beats, and it was like the aesthetic that I wanted, because I consciously went into it knowing the type of project I wanted to make. So aesthetically, that's what it was, and that kind of like built the whole blueprint of what I was trying to make. So to me, that's like my blueprint, in a sense of how like Just Blaze and Kanye kind of like came with the core and the heart of what it was, and then he grabbed other producers like Bank and, you know, other people that added to the cohesiveness of it.
Did anything precede Frio season? You had anything?
Yeah, I got a bunch of projects.
Go ahead, run it. Let's hear it.
I got a project called the Infinity Gauntlet. That shit is like, it's like a compilation more or less of just different songs that I've done from maybe like 2015 to like 2017. I got a bunch of singles, bunch of Lucy's. All my joints is on YouTube, every streaming platform. You know what I'm saying? Frio Isa Blaque, you know, check the description, title, you gonna know how to spell the name. I'm everywhere, so I got a bunch of projects.
The name. When I was posting yesterday, I thought that the song 315 Live, I thought it was featuring somebody. But it's one name, Frio Isa Blaque. Tell me the science behind the whole name. You gave me the Frio.
Right.
But give me the rest.
All right, so my name used to be, originally it was like Black Ice. So then I put a little swag, put a little dribble on it, flipped it, Ice is Blaque. Then, like I said, with the Frio thing, like that's new. Like, cause even though I was always saying Frio, like Frio, then like at one point I was just like, let me put some Frio on it. And then people love that tag. So I'm like, oh shit, I'm just building it, chop, I'm just cooking. You know what I'm saying? Like every time I'm doing something, I'm seeing how people react to it. They loving it. So I added it. So I actually just added that to the name, but it's like, it's more or less like a surname per se, like how they got like ASAP or they got whatever other rap name collectives, and they have the group and then they have the name. So that's what it's kind of is. And then it's like, it's a three-part thing too, because I know it's like a lot of famous people who are like snipers and shit like that. They got like three names and shit. So it's just like, it's a concoction of gumbo and just mad different things.
Got it. Tell me about this latest video. Where was it shot at? You got busy on it. I fuck with
appreciate
it. Obviously,
that.
The fans at Gully TV fucked with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I appreciate
How'd
y'all.
How you feel about that, the response?
Yo, I loved it. I appreciate y'all, man. Because y'all know me from a hole in the wall. And y'all ain't got no reason to lie. Y'all going to give it straight jacking, straight real. If it was trash, niggas going to be like, yo, this shit trash. Gully, don't do this no more. You playing.
I got brutal. They brutal. You know they brutal.
Oh, yeah, facts. But we need that. That's the problem with the game right now. Niggas is just letting shit slide through. And you know what I'm saying? Like, we need that raw shit. So I love it. Once again, I appreciate y'all. But I just shot it locally in the area. We got this. This is casino about 45 minutes from me called Turnstone. It's actually one of the biggest prestigious casinos in the country. So shot it up there. We I had my people's fly in from Houston. And, you know, we just did it. You know what I'm saying? All love. Something real, like, simplistic, but because sometimes you don't need all the bells and whistles every time, especially when it's just, I want to keep it raw, but still give the vibes type of thing. You know what I'm saying? That's one of my favorite songs also, 315 Live. I spit a lot of jewels in there, a lot of quotables, a lot of real shit, real niggas, real females can relate to. And that's what I aim for.
When I listen to your music, I hear the influences of the 5% Nation of Gods and Earths.
Facts.
Tell me something, man. Tell me something. I heard that line you dropped off about Muslim lesson.
Number 32. Number 32. The fuck is you?
All right, tell me what's up. Give me the math behind Muslim lesson. Number 32.
You put me on the spot right now. I ain't gonna hold you. I studied it, you know, as a youth, you know what I'm saying? 16, I got introduced to it. Yeah, like 15, 16. I don't know it off cap, I'm not going to hold you. But I draw my influences from my real life, you know what I'm saying? So But yeah, I ain't got it on cap. I ain't gonna hold you. No, you know it?
Nah.
Yeah,
nah.
See, I ain't got it on cap.
The thing with me, right, because I be around some high power guys. Mm-hmm. I be around Shaheem and them.
Right.
I'm gonna tell you, I'm not gonna tell you what I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna tell you what I do know.
Exactly.
You dig? So anybody ever asks me to show and prove, I'm just gonna start running in this
right,
shit.
Right.
But as far as me knowing the whole 120 at 40, 4 years old,
yeah.
25 years worth of smoking Buddha,
exactly.
You might not get it.
And that's
we
I'm
probably
saying.
Can say it together.
That's what I'm saying.
You started off,
then I started picking it up.
Yeah, that's what I mean. We probably can say it together.
I'm out here living life. I'm doing things. I got 60 things on my plate. So, right. I know the significance of it, but I don't got it on cap.
I live as God.
Exactly.
I live as perfection.
True and living.
Yeah, so that's the end of that.
Exactly.
But 2022, this summer, do you got a EP in the tuck?
I got a few joints I'm working on, but it's a different style type of thing. But I'm about to start working on Frio season 2. See, when I do the Frio seasons, I'm gonna have that as my I can't think of the proper word, but it's like the capsule. So it's like whenever it's like Lil Wayne when he do a Carter, it's like you know what you getting. You getting barred up, you getting, or like a no ceilings or something like that. Like you getting barred up. So it's like each chapter, each Sora with the Frio season, yeah. You know exactly what you're getting. Cause like my music is universal. I make all different types of music because I got my fan base is extensive. But I got people that like me when I do like the new age, but then I got people that just love that nostalgic, real shit. Quote unquote New York sound, so I just try to feed all my people.
I ain't picked up on your new age shit. The only thing that I'm doing.
I mean, you tuned into a frequency,
oh,
so.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? You know how
that
you
gotta tell me this one of them joints right here.
See? Yeah, you tuned into a frequency. That's why, like, I just did what? I did like 3-4 videos recently, but I only sent you that one.
Right.
I know your frequency.
Got it.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I know my fan base, I know my clients, I know my audience.
No
so
doubt.
I feed my audience. It's like. And it's hard when you have an extensive audience versus a niche audience. I don't like to pigeonhole myself into a box, so I just like to, you know what I'm saying? It's like in the street. If you want this, okay, I'm about to go get that now. You know what I'm saying? So it's like that.
We had an earlier conversation about basically the gatekeepers of hip-hop.
Mm-hmm.
People who got it in the choke.
Right.
It's time, right?
It's time.
Go ahead, man. Tell my listeners, man, my viewers, how you feel about, you know, the government that exists in hip-hop and how they're going to rise. Might need a little bit of space, man, a little political power of his own.
Niggas got to move around a little bit, you know what I'm saying? We appreciate you. We appreciate what you contributed to the game and the influences y'all brought. But, you know what I'm saying? It's time to open the window, let that new breeze come in. You know what I'm saying? Like, We ain't against y'all, and we don't want y'all against us. You know what I'm saying? We need to be working together in harmony. So if you up a little higher, pull an arm down, pull us up. You know what I'm saying? Because we gonna take this thing further. We try to stand on the shoulders of giants, and we can take this thing further versus letting them take what we. This is our commodity. This is our biggest commodity, and we gotta keep it ours. You know what I'm saying? So being selfish and being egotistical. And being greedy ain't gonna do it. We gotta work together. You know what I'm saying? What Hope said, remove the sunroof, let the sun shine through. Come on, man, let's get it. Frio. Frio. It's your boy Frio Isa Blaque. Big Poppy Frio from the group home, Master Chef, Lord of the Kitchen Cupboard, AKA Clout Daddy Drew. Let's get it. Breaking down dimes and 50s from a whole zone. Got the weight breaking like turbo and ozone. When you make something from nothing, they try to jail ya. I whip a whole pot of that raw Iggy Azalea. Negro spirituals for thugs that won't fail ya. This is lyrical drug paraphernalia. Frio spit that shit only real niggas could fail. If you got screws loose, then my niggas come in and drill. I'm in the passenger with the mag loading the steel. Dumping out the window while Jesus holding the wheel. Baptize a nigga, make a bird fly. Word I don't even see you bitch niggas with my third eye. If you don't know nothing else, nigga know yourself. Hate, greed, and envy, you a slave to your lower self. Nigga, I'm a king. King with a lion's pelt. I'm a shooting star, 4/5 on the Ryan.